I remember how they laughed. Alliance and Resistance soldiers, eager for battle, trading jokes as we marched east towards the peaks. Beyond this last line of defenses lay the locks and the city. Breaching it would be no small feat. But we beat the Imperials back, just like that. And we liberated a village, the first of many.
Let us see. So, she lives. Impressive. Or merely lucky, though that too may prove a useful trait.
My lord, what have you done to me?
Though we Garlians are intellectually and physiologically superior in almost all respects, we lack the hereditary traits required for the reliable manipulation of ether, hence our unique inability to wield magics. This deficiency, for want of a better word, saw us subjected to decades of oppression by the lesser races, and we were eventually driven to seek shelter in the cold northern reaches of Ilsebar. Fortunately, said region was replete with vast deposits of ceruleum, which proved instrumental in the development of Magitech, a revolutionary technology conceived to compensate for our disadvantage. It was with Magitech that we grew strong, that our nation became an empire. Yet, ultimately, this was an extrinsic solution to an intrinsic problem. What I wanted was not a crude device to be used in lieu of magic. Through modification of the Garlean genome, I argued that it might be possible to enhance a subject's ability to manipulate ether, effectively empowering them to wield magics. Alas, my theories were met with consternation in the Imperial Court. Only Lord Xenos, with commendable foresight and wisdom, deigned to support my research.
You gave me this treatment, but I'm not Garlean.
Alamegan, through and through. What you have been granted is far greater than mere magic. Before that lesser light, it is as a second sun.
I am informed that Alagiri was recently occupied by the Resistance, and that an attack on Specular Imperatoris is considered imminent. This could provide an ideal opportunity to test her performance in the field.
Your skulls, was it? They have joined the garrison at the Watchtower?
Yes, my lord. By your leave, I would rendezvous with them and lead a counterattack against the insurgents.
No. Even were you to leave now, you would not arrive in time. There is another duty I would entrust to you.
You. You've improved, lad.
Come now, father. You lured the fool onto my blade, and do not try to deny it.
Our work here is all but done. What of Conrad and his men?
They are for the main tower. The skulls have offered fierce resistance thus far, but Conrad seems to believe he can convince them to lay down their arms.
Then we will tend to the stragglers down below. With me!
Report.
Enemy forces have overrun the lower facilities and appear to be mounting an assault on the main tower. We have already received a request for reinforcements. A unit of legionaries has been mustered and is ready to depart. They await your orders, Commander.
Stand down.
Commander?
Tell them to stand down.
Commander, if I may... Our people, your people, are still in there. They will be slaughtered.
You think I don't know that? I want nothing more than to help them, to lead the bloody charge. But I have my orders. Lord Zeno said no reinforcements. He would have us use the main cannon to destroy the installation.
What? Kill our own soldiers? You must be mistaken.
Initiate the firing sequence. Wars are won on the backs of the dead. Theirs and ours. There is no truth but this. We must remain firm and resolute and always, always do our duty. Now, give the order.
Initiate firing sequence.
Aye, aye. Initiating firing sequence. Release safety locks. Deploy main cannon.
I need you to confirm the target, Commander.
Specula Imperatoris, main tower. Fire when ready.
Thank you.
door in the Seven Hells!
Long-range artillery!
Those treacherous bastards! Their people were still fighting! Full retreat! Now! Relay the orders!
Understood. All forces retreat! I repeat, all forces retreat!
Conrad! Conrad, speak to me!
It was all so sudden. Conrad had just convinced the last few skulls to surrender when we heard the bang and everything started to shake. We carried the survivors to safety, but Conrad's... We have done what we can for him. All that remains is to pray.
Conrad?
Yeah.
Is that you, Lise? I can't see a damn thing. Well, that's that then. Time's up.
What are you talking about? You'll be on your feet before you know it.
It's all right, Lise. I've lived long enough. But listen, I want you to lead the resistance in my stead.
Don't say another word. You'll recover. We'll recover. We'll bring freedom to El Amigo together. We're not going to stop here.
No, you won't. Everything we've built, everyone we've brought together, I know you'll show them the way. You've got it in you, Lise. Not because you're Curtis's daughter or Ida's sister, but because you're you. Because you're you.
Conrad. I will, Conrad. I will. I promise.
Next round! Double the charge!
Come, Nidhogg. We are needed.
It's the Cerulean Pipeline!
Impossible! How could one man... Shoot that bastard! Shoot him!
Has slain far greater beasts. You're welcome, boy.
Notify all units! I want that intruder found! And get the engineers to fix my bloody cannon! Savages are coming!
Are you all right? Ah, I think that answers my question. We've accomplished our objectives as well.
Lisa's unit should be advancing upon the fire control center in the command tower. Let us join them. Lise! Thank the 12 you're all right.
And you. There's the control center. Let's hit them hard and fast. Ready?
No one else had to die, and you killed them! Your own people! Your own comrades!
You're right! I killed them! Ansfrid, Rudolf, Emlyn, all the rest, trained and fought with every last one of them, good soldiers to a man! I gave the order that led to their deaths, and I knew exactly what I was doing.
But why? Why would you do that?
They died so that all Alamegans could live free. That was all we ever wanted. We made a promise that we would do whatever it took so that one day the Imperials would learn to accept us. But everything comes at a price. And if you haven't got the means to pay, then you pay with blood. Service guarantees citizenship, but citizenship guarantees naught. It's not enough to do your part, oh no. You have to run faster, fight harder, kill more and more and more, and only then will you be equal. That's just how it is out here in the provinces. You buy your freedom with blood. There is no other way.
Shut up! Shut your mouth! You don't get to talk about freedom! You killed your own! They trusted you, and you killed them! Murderer! Butcher! Traitor!
I know what you can do. I've already seen it.
Alize!
Even so, the odds are against me.
You may bring your horde, if you like. All are welcome.
She'll be all right, but we'll need to carry her. Will you help me? Thank you. Lise, I leave matters here in your hands.
Right.